Hello students, welcome to the class on editorial decode, and in this class I will be decoding beyond alliance agendas in Jammu and Kashmir written by Wajahat Habibullah. Now from examination point of view, this will help you in general studies mains examination paper 2, plus this is important for public administration, for history and for political science optional students. Now what is this editorial about? This editorial is about of why and how we need to be more concerned about the real, existent and substantive problems of Jammu and Kashmir. This editorial is also about how we need to be less concerned about the transient questions. The transient questions like who will be forming the government in Jammu and Kashmir, which all parties will be forming the government in Jammu and Kashmir, and is the alliance between the BJP and the PDP a sustainable one or not. Now in order to understand this editorial, first of all we need to understand about the condition of Jammu and Kashmir. Now Jammu and Kashmir is one such state that is a kind of a disputed territory. Now why am I saying it as a disputed territory? A disputed territory because it houses n number of problems. N number of problems with Pakistan. It houses n number of problems from the perspective of China. It houses n number of problems from the perspective of India. Now, if you want a peace, if you want development, if you want Jammu and Kashmir to sustain with India, what India needs to do and how the situation needs to be tackled is a more substantive question to be answered. From 2014 onwards, what we are witnessing in Jammu and Kashmir is a spiraling of the terrorist activities. What we are witnessing is a waxing of the terrorist activities. What we are witnessing is the corruption in the government. What we are witnessing is a lack of bonhomie among the citizens of Jammu and Kashmir. What we are witnessing is the rise of the radicalization of the youth. What we are witnessing is the strengthening of the forces of fundamentalism. What we are witnessing is the lack of governance, because when we look at the situation in Jammu and Kashmir, it was badly handled by the government in the aftermath of the huge floods that came in 2014. Now, if you want this state to have peace, if you want to endure peace, if you want to endure development in this region, we need to create, we need to engender something that is non-existent till now. Now, what is this non-existent I'm talking about? Non-existent is in terms of the economic opportunities that needs to be provided to this state. Economic opportunities in terms of opening up mega food parks, setting up horticulture zones, setting up special economic zones, pumping in the money so that the startups could come up from this region. And along with that, we also need to tinker with the education system of Jammu and Kashmir so that the youth of the Jammu Kashmir don't feel alienated from India. They should love the idea of India. They should feel Indianness in them. And this Indianness can be imbibed, this Indianness can be inculcated in them if we will offer them the opportunities full of choices in terms of employment, in terms of education, in terms of enriching themselves, in terms of creating a better future for themselves. Now, if you look at the present situation in Jammu and Kashmir, the youth of Jammu and Kashmir, they are only inclined towards government jobs and they are not inclined towards setting up their own ventures, and they are lacking in the entrepreneurial spirit. And this entrepreneurial spirit should be imbibed in them. Only then we will be able to create a kind of a human resource that will feel more close towards India and the idea of Indianness. Then apart from this thing, another thing that needs to be done is to create forces which can help to erase the fault line between the Hindus and the Muslims existing over there. Now, how can this fault line be eroded? How can this be erased? How can this fault line be done away with? This can be done away with if the citizens of Jammu and Kashmir will work vigorously to magnetize the Hindus that had fled Jammu and Kashmir quite decades ago. Because it is only upon the citizens to create a situation of tranquility, to create a situation of esprit de corps, to create a situation of brotherhood. The government cannot sustain up with such issues when it relates to the of caste, color and creed. The issues of caste, color and creed, they are better tackled from within the citizenry rather than being imposing these things on the citizenry. Because the citizenry actually repulses back. Such kind of changes should be brought from within. And such kind of changes should be sui generis. Apni khud ki changes honi chahiye, jo aapko long term chahiye, aur aapko lagta hai ki ye endure kar payengi, sustain kar payengi, chal payengi. So this was all for the editorial decode. You can subscribe to this channel. Name of the channel is IAS Mentors. You can contact me at 8459400000 in case you're interested in buying the video classes on entire civil services preparation. And in order to avail the information of the classes that we are offering, please visit our websites eiasmentors.com and brainiki.com. And in case you have liked this video, do click on the like button, do share and comment on this video. So this was all for the day. Bye bye. Take care. Have a nice night.